I'm the independent chair of the local safeguarding children board here in Brighton and Hove. And what that means is that I oversee a statutory board that has responsibility for coordinating and assuring the child safeguarding system in Brighton and Hove. So it's my job to make sure that agencies work together effectively to keep children safe. We published last week a serious case review into the deaths of two young men. We never name people in serious case review, so we call them W and X, but lots of people know who they are. They very tragically were killed in 2014, having made the decision to go over to Syria to fight with a group which turned out to be associated with Al-Qaeda. Because of their deaths, I decided that we would carry out the serious case review because I wanted to see whether or not there was anything that agencies could have done differently, particularly in their earlier life, to stop them going down the route whereby they felt that it was the right thing to do to put themselves in such danger. So the review took quite a long time. It was a very complex review, a lot of people involved, a lot of agencies to speak to, a huge amount of information. These weren't young people who were off the radar, they were very much in plain sight. Eventually the review came out last week, as I say, and the findings were quite wide-ranging, actually, but they're around three themes, really. So firstly, we found that agencies in the city are not well equipped to deal with and to provide services to families and children who have suffered long-term trauma in their early lives, because sometimes that long-term trauma and the way it's dealt with previously can affect how families and children receive offers of support from agencies. So we need to find a different way of being able to make the services more tailor-made for families in those situations and flexible in the way that they're delivered. Okay. It also found that where there are signs of what we would call exploitation, and that could be exploitation to go into terrorist organisations as happened here, or sexual exploitation, those early signs of vulnerability are quite common across all forms of exploitation with young people. And what agencies didn't do in this case was identify them as such. So we're looking at the way they work together to first of all, pick up on those initial clues that children are vulnerable and could well be exploited, and then how collectively they deal with them. And the third point was around the really understanding and using the local communities to be part of the solution to this. So this family came from a Muslim community, they were quite embedded in the Muslim community, but the review found that agencies didn't really understand the cultural and religious beliefs and implications of being in such a community, and didn't use the community to try and access them to provide services to help support them.